This is the current status of my 3D printer for more than a year already. It doesn't have its own dedicated table. The tools are just hanging. The filaments are just placed anywhere. I guess it's time the printer has its new table with cabinet for storage. The dimensions are customized to accommodate the size of the printer and storage for tools and filaments. I will be using a 3/4 inch plywood and cover it with laminate both inside and outside. Using a laminate is expensive, but it's totally worth it once you see the finished product. I am not going to use my table saw on this project. All cutting will be made using the track saw. This will demonstrate that track saws are very accurate. As you can see, setting up your track saw is very fast. If you are still using a circular saw to break down your plywood, you should start saving money for a track saw. This is the laminate that will be used in this project. The wood design is for the outside and the white one is for the inside. Rolling your laminate, just as shown in the video, is the easiest way to handle them when moving. If you don't handle them properly, they might break. If you already have your plywood cut to its dimensions, just lay them on the laminate like in the video and mark your cut lines. Just leave 1 inch clearance on all sides. Arrange your cut that it will maximize your laminate usage. This is very important because laminate is expensive. After finishing marking the cut lines, I will be using my track saw to cut the laminate. There are many ways to cut your laminate. I have tried most of them and found out that the track saw is the most efficient way to cut it. If you don't have a track saw, just use your circular saw. For applying contact cement, make sure to sand your workpiece. Then clean them properly so no dust and debris will get caught in between. I am putting the laminate first before assembly because it is easier this way. This will be the inside of the cabinet. There are many ways you can apply contact cement. The method I am using is the spreader method. I made the spreader myself using a 3D printer. I have searched the internet for this and I cannot find one here in the Philippines. So, I decided to 3D print one and it works perfectly well. There are many videos on YouTube explaining how to use this method. Please search for it if you're interested. I am putting the white laminate first before assembly because it is easier this way. This will be the inside part of the cabinet. It is very hard and time consuming to laminate the inside part once it is already finished. The other option is to just paint the inside. Painting the inside is much easier than putting laminate. In trimming the excess, you can use a palm router with a flush trimming bit. But I will use my router table because it is convenient and fast. After putting the white laminate, next step is to assemble it. Putting the laminate first does make the job easier. If you work alone most of the time, invest in long clamps. This will help you with the assembly. Time to lay out the laminate for the outside. Before doing that, I am going to cut 22 mm sized for the edges of the cabinet door and tabletop. Since the laminate is too dark to see a pencil mark, I will put masking tape so I can see the fine pencil mark. If you cannot find the edge banding that will match your laminate, this will be your only option. Cut small strips of laminate for the edges. Again, a track saw is more than capable of doing this. Measure the total length that you need for the edges. In this project, I will need to cut 3 8-foot small strips. I already have the measurements to cut written on the scrap wood. Since the laminate is too dark for a pencil, I will use a white paint marker. Again, I will use my track saw to cut the laminate. As you can see, using the track saw makes cutting the laminate look easy. The clear white markings also is a big help. My track saw is cordless. The black thing you see attached to it is the vacuum hose. After transferring to a small indoor shop, I have attached vacuum to some of my power tools. Inside the plastic bottle is contact cement. There is a very small hole on the cap of the bottle. Using this method to apply rugby in a small area, like an edge, is very convenient. You can control the amount of flow by how hard to press on the plastic. Thank you. The red and blue are rubber mats. They will protect the laminate from scratches while you work on the table. This is going to be the tabletop. I will laminate the edges first. Prepare the edges by sanding it, then cleaning it. Clamp the workpiece on a vise. Then put contact cement on all sides of the edge. This is how I put contact cement on the laminate, again using the plastic bottle method. Since this is very long to handle, rolling it like this helps. After 15 to 20 minutes of drying, attach the laminate to the edge. Clamp the workpiece like shown in the video. Then carefully attach the laminate. Since it has a round corner, attach your laminate just as shown in the video. Then carefully press the laminate as not to break it. Use a wood with cloth or a roller. In trimming the excess, use your router with flush trimming bit. Use this kind of attachment that comes with your router. You may also not use this if you don't have it, but I prefer to use it because it makes the router easy to control, especially in the round corners. After trimming, you can use your orbital sander with 120 grit to clean the edges. I am putting laminate this way because this will be the bottom side. You only need to put laminate on the sides because that's the only part that will be seen. You will see that later in the video. A quick tip, if you want to put contact cement on a specific area, use masking tape. Just like painting, masking tape is very handy in the workshop. Another tip, I always use the timer on my cell phone every time I use contact cement. This way, I always keep track of the drying time. To trim the edges, I will use my AH703 trimmer with 1 mm round over bit. This is a specialized edge trimmer for laminates. In the future, I will make a video about this specialized trimmer tool. Do let me know in the comments section if you're interested in that video. I am attaching this first to the table before laminating the top side. it's time to laminate the top side. I know the video is already very long. You can just fast forward it to the end if you want to look at the final product. I am including this in the video in case someone is interested to see this for learning purposes. Laminate when upside down is very slippery. The blue thing I am using is just a weight to hold the laminate. It's just a gear from a heavy machinery. It has three pointy legs which I 3D printed so that it will not damage the contact cement. This technique in applying the contact cement is very tricky for newbies. The only way you will get used to this is by practicing a lot. So before you try this on an expensive project, practice a lot first on scrap wood. Practice with white laminate. It's the cheapest laminate that I know of. One practice I did is I made my router table from laminate, the one you saw in the video. Contact cement drying time is very tricky. The time to dry is not fixed. Sometimes it's 10 minutes, sometimes it's 15 minutes, or sometimes longer. The way I see it, drying time depends on the weather outside. If the sun is out and it's shining very bright, the drying time is fast. But there is no sun, it's very cloudy, or sometimes there is little rain, or it is raining very hard, then drying time is longer. I don't recommend heat gun to assist drying time. I can recommend electric fan because contact cement needs good air circulation to dry. In trimming the excess, I am just using my AH703 electric trimmer. This is a specialized tool for laminates. Here in the Philippines, I bought this online through Lazada. This is expensive, but I think it's well worth it. Once the excess is trimmed, press your laminate again. This time, put more weight on it. I don't have an expensive roller, but my wood and cloth method does an excellent job. Done properly, this wood and cloth method will rival those expensive rollers for laminates. We're almost at the finish line. Installing the cabinet door is usually done last. These cabinet doors were pre-installed and aligned when there was still no laminate. This way, if there are errors, it will not damage the laminate. After it was installed and aligned properly, they were then disassembled. It's finally finished. I am happy with the laminate I chose. The inside of the cabinet doesn't need to be laminated. You can also just paint it. But this project is to demonstrate how you can laminate all parts of the cabinet. After more than a year, my 3D printer will finally have its own table with cabinet for storage of tools and filaments. The storage can accommodate up to 28 spools of standard 1 kilo filaments and all the tools needed for maintenance and repair of the printer. For those wanting to buy a 3D printer, it's not a plug-and-play machine. It needs love and care to properly work. You need to know how to properly maintain it for it to function properly. But don't be afraid. There are a lot of YouTube videos to guide you if you need help on fixing it. With the old table, every time I print, the table will shake because it is not very solid. With this table, that no longer happens. I know it is a long video, but for those who want to laminate an entire cabinet for their project, I hope you learned something. Hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching.